Our project this evening is to bring together the various elements of this series of discussions on the mysticism of the Kabbalah. And perhaps there is no better way of climaxing our little program of research than through the symbolism of the everlasting house. Nearly all peoples scattered throughout the culture systems of mankind who have attained a high platform of ethics or civilization have conceived that the ultimate purpose of human society is to create or reveal through conduct a way of life that brings peace, harmony, dignity, and honor to all men. In Buddhism, for example, we have the tradition of the Maitreya, the teacher who is to come and who is to rule over an enlightened world. Certainly, the messianic concept in Christianity sustains this same general teaching. In Hindu India, the concept of the 10th avatar of Vishnu, the one who is to come, who is to restore the sacred institutions and to bring human beings together in brotherhood and fraternity. This avatar also is to rule over an enlightened world. We also have among most peoples the idea that heaven is a vast empire, that like the kingdom of earth, the kingdom of heaven is the orderly abode of the sovereign deities and powers that govern the world. Old nations conceived of heaven as a magnificent palace city, a city perfect, like the New Jerusalem, a city wherein the blessed and the redeemed dwelt together in eternal bliss.
In the depths of the Second World War, when just about everything had gone wrong, the government sketched out a vision of the post-war New Jerusalem that they wanted to build. And that's what we're doing now.
The old Egyptians had the same kind of a philosophy. They believed that in the world of the gods was the splendid palace temple of Osiris, Lord of the quick and the dead, and that from his throne this great deity administered not only his own spiritual domain, but prepared the way for the descent of his spiritual kingdom into the mortal world, where it would be led and guarded and guided and ruled by his beloved son, Horus, the Golden Hawk. Thus, everywhere, man had the internal archetypal vision of a world fashioned to his heart's desire. A world in which the evils that we know are no more, but that all things are ruled and governed in righteousness, and that after a certain length of time, the kings and rulers of this world would return their crowns and scepters to the Eternal King, and that the Great One who fashioned all things will finally be the full ruler of his redeemed peoples. The older peoples, including the Jewish mystics, recognized that there were two orders of government: government by men and government by God. The governments of men might be splendid, luxurious, magnificent, and their palaces bewildered the senses. But these governments by men were in large measure corrupt. Selfishness, egotism, tyranny were always present, and the rich and the powerful exploited the weak and the helpless. Thus there was no real solution to man's dream of a golden age to be found merely in the temporal estates of nations.
I do not think it vainglorious or implausible to say that a new golden age for this United Kingdom is now within reach, and in spite of the scoffing, in spite of the negativity, in spite of the scepticism that you will hear from the other side, we will work flat out to deliver it.
Also, we must realize that the archetype of the ultimate state of man was strangely related to this mysterious experience of man's origin. If the future is to become increasingly better, the remote past was also better. For in the ancient times, it was believed that the gods walked with men, that the ways of heaven flourished upon earth, and that at the very beginning of time, divine institutions were established for the good of men, that laws were revealed, and that the first civilizers of nations were divinely inspired and spiritually enlightened beings. These too are vanished away in the limbo of things forgotten. But we seem to have a lingering memory of the golden age that once was. And it gives us a certain symbolism about the golden age that is to come.